Hello, Chloe. How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. It seems like we're in the same place, apparently. We're in the same
place. I know. Look at that. We're basically together.
Después de toda una vida de ser los enemigos más famosos del mundo, Tom y Jerry están a punto de comenzar de nuevo.
It's so nice to have you here. And I have to ask you, you know, you've worked with so many people before, but how would you describe Tom and Jerry as your co-stars, and where did it allow you to go as an actress as well?
Tom and Jerry are by far the most diva. No.
Especially Jerry. He seems like a very hard part.
He's such a diva. He had to have cheese all the time, and Tom just had to have his milk heated to exactly, you know, 73 degrees. No. it was a really, really fun experience. It was daunting, to say the least, being that they were, you know, not actually speaking to me and not present on set most of the time. But it was an experience. I think that now, after having done it, I feel like I'm a better actor now because of having the ability to be a part of this project.
Before this, I did Narcos, you know, in Mexico, and you kind of just react to everything that's already there. Somebody shooting at you, you're like, you know, and you're shooting back at them, and then you're trying to, you know, your objective is very clear and cut as to what your character wants. And here, it's a little bit different because it's got to be bigger, and you have to really commit yourself to that world. But at the same time, you know, when it's bigger, kids love that stuff. And hopefully, like my son actually loved it, when he saw it. And it's always, you know, it just makes you feel good when your kid likes it, you know?
Este hotel ha recibido a 4 presidentes, 3 papas, 2 reyes, y ahora tendremos la boda del siglo.
¿Crees estar calificada para este puesto?
Brillo bajo presión, como un diamante. Por Rihanna.
The whole thing to make a film like this work is to make believe. And I was wondering, what was the key to get the actors in this mindset while filming Tom and Jerry?
That's a really good question. Luckily, we had a chance to sit down and talk about just kind of what we were doing, and so all of the actors had dealt with something like this in their past, in their experience. And I think what it was is we could never, although we had to keep it grounded in terms of their relationships and basically what was going on, we also had to give ourselves a little leniency to be silly and just kind of not limit ourselves into trying to make this too grounded. Because in creating the existence or the coexistence of animation with live action, we don't want to be cartoonish, but at the same time, we have to let these cartoons live. And what was fun about it is all the actors really just kind of took this on and found a realism about who they were that that I think kind of tonally, from a standpoint, it worked. And sometimes I wish I knew exactly what they used as actors, but I do know that we had conversations and just said, guys, let's keep it real, but at the same time, let's not take ourselves too seriously.
As an actress, how do you keep your imagination going and ready for projects like this? Like, is there a way to be prepared for something like this?
You know, for me, I don't think there's any quite way to prepare to jump into a project like this right off the bat. But I really wanted to glean kind of comedy notes from Roger Rabbit and, of course, from Lucille Ball. And those are two things that I really wanted to integrate into my character and how far we could kind of push the boundaries with Tom and Jerry. And of course, working closely with the animators to see how far can I go. And what the answer was the more I improv and the more I make up what they're doing, they can actually animate that. So the more I move or I act like they're on my shoulder or I act like they're, you know, running between my legs, they can animate that more so. So it was a very interesting experience.
Una cosa más.
Hay un problema con un ratón.
¿Hay un qué? Yo lo cazaré. Everybody gonna shine. I was born like this, don't even gotta try. Ay, wow, qué detallado.
What I love about this film, especially your character, is that I think it kind of resembles you because you built a career from a very young age. And I'm guessing you also had to prove yourself to get your first project. So do you remember what was that thing that you had to prove to get your first role?
Yeah, I definitely, I mean, growing up you in the industry, you definitely have to tell a few white lies to get people to book you on some jobs. I mean, one, I had to lie to Martin Scorsese for Hugo Cabret, because they were only at the time looking at English actresses for the character of Isabel. And when I auditioned with Asa Butterfield in our chemistry read, I had lied to Marty when he asked where I was from, and I told him I was from Cambridge in England, and that my parents were horse farmers. I had like a whole story about this fake life that I've led. And I ended up booking the part. And then once I had booked it, I did tell him into production that it was very much so a big lie, and that I'm from Georgia. I'm from the South, like the furthest you can possibly get from England in terms of accent. So that was a lie I told.
And when I first got to Hollywood, it literally said Michael Peña, and I was an extra in a movie, and that's it. And I had to, you know, when it says special interest, I was like, you know, I like to box, I like to run, I like to watch TV. Like, it was just, I just filled it with the most random stuff. Just like a profile. I was born in Chicago, blah, blah, blah. But literally my credit was that I was an extra in a movie, and that was it. If you're gonna get a movie where you have to ice skate, they're gonna see you ice skating. Nobody's gonna wait. You know, it takes $30 to, you know, even back then, to like to see if the person can ice skate. And they're like, I'm a great skater. And they're, you know, then you're not gonna get the part. Exactly.
Dejaré que un gato y un ratón vayan a arruinar este hotel.
Juega con nosotros.
Creo que tal vez logré esto.
¿En serio?